Good morning to all. Today we start the new lesson, that's 14th chapter, Sources of Energy. In this chapter, we discussed about that what is a good source of energy and what are fossil fuels, and then solar energy, thermal energy, hydropower energy, and then biomass, energy from the sea, nuclear energy, geothermal energy. These are the topics which we discuss in this chapter. First, we go to that what is a good source of energy? Good source of energy. What is a good source of energy? That characteristics of the good source of energy are that which is safe and convenient to use. Convenient to use. And then second is that easy to transport. Easy to transport. Third, easy to store. Fourth, it should be economical. And fifth, large amount of work. Per unit volume. Per unit volume or mass. Okay. This type of characters which have that sources of energy, that is called as a good source of energy. Safe and convenient to use, and then easy to transport. One place to another, it can be easy to transport. Easy to store, it can be stored in a proper way. So, and economically, it should be means it should be a cheap, which can be available of easily to all the people. And large amount of work per unit volume or mass. This having a characteristics energy called as a good source of energy. Okay, now we go to that discuss about that. What is a conventional sources of energy? What is a conventional sources of energy? Conventional sources of energy. The definition of the conventional sources of energy means the sources of energy which are exhaustible. Which are exhaustible. What is meant by exhaustible? Exhaustible means which can be finished. It means one day that source become finished, that is called as an exhaustible, and have been formed in nature long ago. Okay, called as a conventional sources of energy. The definition of conventional sources of energy is the sources of energy which are exhaustible and have been formed in nature long ago. That is called as a conventional sources of energy. The best example is wood and fossil fuels. Now we discussed about the topic, that is fossil fuels. That fossil fuels are two types. That's one is examples of a fossil fuel is coal and petroleum. First we discussed about that. What is the definition of fossil fuel? Millions of years ago, that some plants and animals which are got buried deep inside that earth are changed into a fuel due to the excess of heat and high pressure, called as a fossil fuels. Once again, I explained the definition of the fossil fuel. That is, millions of years ago, plants and animals were buried deep inside the earth and changed into fuel. How it changed? Due to the excess of heat and high pressure. That is called as a fossil fuels. Okay, now go to that discussed in the fossil fuel is coal. So which is available in the nature, it formed that in long years ago that plants and were buried into that soil and converted into as a fuels. So that with the high temperature and pressure that formed as a coal. Okay, coal is a black material which is mixture of carbon and compounds of carbon. Okay, that consists of hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. Okay, you know that the what are the uses of coal? Coal is used for heating purpose in homes and in industries. Coal is used in that heating purpose in homes and industries, and it is used in a fuel in thermal power plants, mainly thermal power plants we discussed in the later in this chapter. And then manufacture of coke fuel gas like coal gas, synthetic petrol and synthetic natural gas, these are the uses of coal. Okay, next we go to the second fossil fuel is petroleum. Petroleum is derived from the two words petra means in the, that is rock, oleum means oil. It's derived from two words, that is petra means rock and oleum means oil. This is the petroleum meaning, rock and oil. And it's taken from the Greek word. Okay, petroleum word is taken from the Greek word, that petra means rock and oleum means oil. It is a dark colored, viscous and foul smelling. Viscous means that is thickness is more. Okay, and then how is formed? That is also formed by that same process that millions of years ago, that's also some animals are buried into that soil and have the high temperature and pressure that converted as a petroleum. Okay, and we get from petroleum what? Petrol, diesel, kerosene, paraffin wax, natural gas, that is natural gas, that's LPG and CNG. Okay, you know that what is that uses of LPG? LPG full form is, what is the LPG full form? Liquefied petroleum gas. Liquefied petroleum gas. And CNG, compressed natural gas. Compressed natural gas. This is called as a natural gas. Okay, which is used as a fuel. Okay, it's high calorific value. These are both are the high calorific value and clean domestic fuel also we used as a, and smokeless and does not form ash. It's a smokeless, so it does not cause any pollution. It completely combustion. Okay, so that's why it's a good source of fuel. Okay, now we go to that disadvantages of fossil fuel. Disadvantages of fossil fuel. You know that a lot of burning of fossil fuel, what does happen? It causes pollution. It causes majorly air pollution. And by burning the fossil fuel, greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide released, okay, which causes that greenhouse effect, that and also a global warming effect, okay. Then it does not completely burn, okay, it's half, not completely burnt, is half, yeah, 75% it burns. That's why it causes pollution, air pollution, okay. And it is also limited in nature also, okay. It's a non-renewable resource. You know that what is a non-renewable resources, okay. First, you know, discuss that what is a renewable resources, and then what is a non-renewable resources first, okay. Renewable resources. Renewable sources of energy. Those sources of energy which are being produced continuously in nature, called as renewable sources of energy, and these are inexhaustible also. These are also called inexhaustible resources. Inexhaustible resources, okay. Next we go to that non-renewable resources. You can write down that example also. Renewable sources, that is a water cycle, that's water, wind. So this is a renewable sources of energy, and non-renewable resources are, it's also, you add that solar energy is also renewable, non-renewable sources of energy. That is, those sources of energy, which are limited in nature, okay. Those sources of energy which are limited in nature, which cannot be produced by continuously in nature, okay, which cannot be produced continuously in nature. Called as a non-renewable sources, and these are also called as a exhaustible resources. Exhaustible sources of energy, okay. Example mainly, that is fossil fuels, that is coal and petroleum. Once it's the product is ends, it does not again renewable, okay. That's why it's a non-renewable resources, and also called as exhaustible sources of energy, okay. So we already discussed what is that, what is a good sources of energy, and what is a conventional sources of energy, what are fossil fuels, what are that uses of fossil fuel,
What are the disadvantages of fossil fuels? What is the renewable sources of energy? What is the non-renewable sources of energy and examples there? Now we discussed about that thermal power plant. Thermal power plant. What is a thermal power plant? What is the mean of the thermal? Thermal means, I already told you in the first chapter in chemistry, thermal means heat. Okay, by the help of the heat that produces the electricity, called as a thermal power plant. Okay, so first we write down the term, definition. What is a thermal power plant? What is large amount of fossil fuels are burnt every day in power plants or stations to heat up water. Heat up water to produce steam. To produce steam, which further runs the turbine. To generate electricity. That is called as a thermal power plant. So in thermal power plant, how it is, a big tank, or that's tank is there, it's filled, that steel plant like this big tank, just like constructed, and fill that water inside that tank, and majorly coal or whatever are used to burn it, with a lot to burn it, and this covered and connected to in a pipe, so that again here also the a turbine is fitted here. This turbine means it's just like in a fan like structures, blades are there, a turbine. A turbine is fitted. As that steam is passes through this pipe, the turbine becomes rotate. That after the turbine is rotated, this turbine rotates. Here one generator is fitted here. Here a generator is fitted. In that generator, electric wire, that's for transmission of power, that's electricity, a wire is connected to here. At the end of the generator, this is the generator. Okay, that it rotates, as the steam is passes here near the turbine become rotates speedly, that is mechanical energy, that again that end of that turbine connected to a generator, so that's converted into electrical energy. That is converted into electrical energy. Again, this after that water used, again the water is collected here downside and it comes into the here again, it fills that water tank again. So like this, the process is going on in the thermal power plant. That's a lot of heat is by the help of the coal, that is heat is produced. That heat that inside the tank, what is present, what water is present, from that water it converted into steam. That steam again passes speedily helps to rotate the turbine. The turbine, after the rotation, and that end of the turbine is connected to a generator that helps to that mechanical energy converted into electrical energy. Such type of plants are called as the thermal power plant. Okay, by the help of the heat produce electricity or generate electricity, called as a thermal power plant. Next, what is the disadvantages here? The more heat is necessary, we used lot of fossil fuel, that is coal. We use a lot of coal, which is a non-renewable resources. Okay, so that is the disadvantages. And what is the advantages? It helps to convert that mechanical energy into electrical energy, which is generate that electric energy and passes through that suppliers, that's wires. Okay, this is called as a thermal power plant. And then from the next class we discussed about that hydropower plants, and then what is the advantages, its and disadvantages, and what is biomass, and what is wind energy. These are the topics we discussed in that next class. Okay, thank you.